When was the last time you stepped outside on a clear night, gazed heavenwards, and felt that familiar spark of wonder stir inside? For thousands of years, humans have been drawn to space's allure, that alluring cosmic dance of light and possibility unfolding overhead since before our ancestors' time. These days, space beckons louder than ever. A new generation of rockets stands ready to fly higher and farther than before. Secret space planes await covert missions in low orbit, while back on Earth, scientists puzzle over how to rescue beloved telescopes in distress. Yes, the very age of space exploration is undergoing a dramatic renaissance, one rife with opportunity yet shadowed by uncertainty. Let's rewind a few years back when SpaceX was still running early tests of its towering Falcon Heavy rocket. Despite the vehicle's formidable design on paper, success was far from assured. Many observers wondered if the mammoth rocket would truly live up to hype on launch day, or simply fizzle as so many ambitious projects do. Yet the Falcon Heavy did not fizzle. It soared and thundered mightily into space, then beyond expectations by smoothly recovering two of its first stage rocket boosters post-launch. No small feat given the vehicle's complexity. In that December 2017 test, SpaceX showed rivals and skeptics alike that their scrappy ingenuity warranted respect. Fast forward 4 years, over 30 successful Falcon Heavy launches, and numerous incremental design tweaks later, and the rocket keeps achieving new feats. Its latest accomplishment, preparing to launch the mysterious X-37B robotic spaceplane, higher and farther than before on a classified mission for the US military. This upcoming launch marks a significant alliance between launch newcomer SpaceX and the US Space Force, a collaboration unthinkable even a decade ago given Musk's outsider status. It also opens an action-packed new chapter in space exploration, one filled with immense opportunities, as well as rising stakes. Because it's not just legacy rocket companies charging ahead these days, thanks to ballooning government space budgets. No, the playing field grows more crowded by the month as private space startups worldwide enter the orbital arena, each pursuing their own launch vehicles, satellite dreams, and yes, boundless ambition. Take China's Zhuke2 rocket built by startup Landspace. Zhuke2 represents that nation's first successful foray into methane-powered orbital launch vehicles. This advanced propulsion technology promises better efficiency, plus the ability to refuel with lunar or Martian resources someday. Although the Zhuke2 suffered failure on its very first orbital test flight last year, destroying valuable satellites in the process, engineers refined the vehicle's designs until achieving success this summer. Now with the dummy payload safely tested in orbit, Landspace gears up to demonstrate an actual satellite deployment next, a critical proof point if Zhuke2 hopes to compete internationally. Up in space, veteran telescopes like Hubble face worrisome emergencies of their own too. With its gyroscopes failing after over 30 years of stellar service, Hubble may go dark unless a timely rescuer intervenes. But who now possesses the capability and resources to service such an aging orbital sentinel? Hubble resides in an era when most satellites lacked features to enable easy crewed repair and upgrades in orbit. NASA's retired space shuttles performed such servicing calls 5 times over Hubble's lifetime, adding new cameras and hardware so the spacecraft could continuously evolve. But with the shuttle fleet mothballed, Hubble's future hangs in the balance, as newer satellites blast off with minimal repair options built in at best. So you see, space exploration finds itself at a technological crossroads. As more nations and companies justifiably pursue their celestial ambitions, Earth orbit grows more commercially indispensable, yet geopolitically complex by the day. In such an environment, striking innovative alliances and balancing collective priorities becomes critical to continued sustainable progress in orbit and beyond. Collaboration enables breakthroughs, while fierce, unchecked competition risks collisions and conflict 24/7 in Earth's crowded orbital alleyways, not just physically but in terms of adversaries undercutting and engaging in electronic warfare against each other's space assets. Amidst today's shifting space landscape, opportunity and risk travel hand in hand, like explorers of old beholden to the vagaries of chance and weather. Huge payoffs await those organizations with vision plus engineering courage to attempt what was recently impossible in the heavens. Yet setbacks and losses remain one faulty valve or line of buggy code away, and no one escapes misfortune in space exploration forever as a rule. Just ask Jeff Bezos after Amazon's Project Kuiper satellite went kaput upon launch last year, or the Starliner team at Boeing still working to nail tricky orbital rendezvous procedures after nearly a decade in development. Yes, private space companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin now rival government agencies in resources, innovation, and long-term vision, while space startups worldwide dare to pursue missions and dreams, once solely held by ultra-wealthy spacefaring nations. Without doubt, the widening pool of players signals more investment in humanity's shared future in orbit and out into the solar system. An abundance of space startups and manned missions benefits science, security, the economy, and beyond. But it also raises pressing philosophical questions as we sail deeper into the stars together, yet divided by earthly disagreements. How do we equitably balance opportunity and risk, while upholding ethics and high ideals as more diverse players join the great cosmic game? Can near-Earth space especially remain a zone relatively protected from future terrestrial conflicts, as orbital assets controlling navigation, communication, weather, and more become indispensable? And ultimately, does prioritizing responsible exploration and science best serve the long-term survival interests of humankind back on fragile Earth? Or does a shift toward thinking of space itself as a possible backup drive for preserving our species make sense given mounting terrestrial tensions? The answers remain unclear as yet, my friends. But of a few things I'm quite certain after studying space all these years, Earth still has so much to gain inspirationally from the heavens. If we approach with care, vision, and a healthy dose of humility, the cosmos remains a gateway to our better selves. If we open our hearts as well as our eyes to the majesty and teachings available overhead every single night, I believe space still calls us subtly towards progress, compassion, and global community in a language beyond mere vocabulary. For its starry silence lifts us above terrestrial disagreements whenever we peer up and truly listen using more than our ears. The celestial realm greets all peaceful explorers. So as multiple rockets soon ignite in thunder and smoke to propel diverse new spacecraft to fresh horizons, let us voyage outwards together with renewed hope in our souls, no matter who built the vessels. The next breathtaking chapter in humanity's space odyssey still awaits. If we have the courage, thanks for listening, friends. Let's meet again soon.